Joining the 21st century, Barack Obama has created his second Twitter account, one for business and one for play. Yes, for years Obama's been using his personal account to tweet, but has officially taken control of the presidential account at POTUS, because apparently that's a thing that needs to exist. Now, taking control of such an account increases his social media presence, but it can also be a negative. In Obama's case, it's hundreds of fans being, well, sexually explicit would be an understatement.
Disgusting.
Years from now, they're going to think that's poetry.
The best part of that tweet is the White House archives all correspondence in compliance with the Presidential Records Act. So that means it's on an official document forever. But at least Old Mate hasn't tweeted anything offensive himself. Other people haven't been so smart, begging the question, should celebrities run their own Twitter accounts? Apparently not. In 2011, comedian and voice of cartoon Birds Everywhere. Gilbert Gottfried tweeted, well, actually tweeted a lot of jokes about the Japanese earthquake.
Japan called me. They said maybe those jokes are ahead in the US, but over here they're sinking.
An earthquake that killed almost 16,000 people. Gilbert was then fired from being the voice of an insurance company's spokesduck. Not a joke, that's a real thing.
I'm glad we got Affleck, huh?
Affleck!
A job that he'd held for 11 years. If only they didn't do 75% of their business in Japan. Surprisingly though, he's still tweeting. On the other hand, when a tweet posted from the Colbert Report official Twitter account by one of his staffers read, the Cancel Colbert campaign was started, and in response the account was deleted, so no one else could tweet in Colbert's voice ever again. The worst of them though was probably our very own Olympic swimmer Stephanie Rice. Her tweet came after a Wallabies victory over South Africa, and wasn't even a joke.
Suck on that, faggots!
And with those four words, she lost a sponsorship deal with Jaguar and the $100,000 car they loaned her. That's a $25,000 per word tweet. Bad idea, Steph. Needless to say, it's been difficult for Steph to get any new sponsors. Let's just hope Obama doesn't follow in their footsteps.